Hello, today we finish the topic of SOP operators for work with splines. Today we're going to check two spline modeling operators called Clay and CurveClay. So let's start our first part. I will take the result of 12th lesson and let's create the Clay operator. So basically we can use this operator to model, to change the shape of geometry without selecting the control vertices, and we can work using the parametrical selection. So basically first we can select U and V coordinate, then we can define the warping method. We have several choices. We have matrix, which provide us a possibility to use translate, rotate, scale and pilot transformations. We can also use the easiest way for my taste, just to use vector. And then we can use either normal vector or the unclick the normal and use the custom vector. So let's stay on the normal vector and let me check the display flag for the edited geometry. So you can see that we have some strange peak coming from the geometry. Let's try to control it. So we can change the U coordinate and we can change the V coordinate, and you see how that's working. Then I can go back to the Clay page and change the distance in minus range, and then we can control the shape by using the U and V sharpness parameters. And also we can change U and V bias, which will offset the center point of deformation. Okay, that is quite easy. We have also the second choice. We can connect the primitive to deform to, and that can be any spline primitive. For example, let me copy and paste that clay. Then I can create a sphere, for example, and connect it to the second input and convert it to the NURBS, change the radius. And let me display it also here. Switch to wireframe mode. So now I can choose the primitive option in work method. Then the deformed position point will jump to 0, 0 coordinate on the deform to primitive. And then I can change that by changing these parameters. Then maybe I can unclick the bias, and then it will match completely. So that was a clay SOP. And now let's speak about the curve clay. So let's first create it, curve clay. We can choose also two workflows. First way to work is to project some curve onto geometry. And that's what the warning message is telling us. There are no profiles on the surface. For that, we might need some geometry, for example, a circle. Then we can use the project SOP. And then we should connect the 3D face to project on the first input and geometry to project to on the second input. And then we can choose, for example, the parametrical method. We should change the type of geometry to the NURBS curve. And then we can connect the output to the curve clay. So now we should change the displacement and we can adjust the range of UV range of the circle. Maybe let's change the radius. So that's basically how it's working. Maybe we can play a bit more with the V range. And now you can obviously see the deformation coming from the circle on the surface of our vase. Then we also can change the several parameters. Here we can change the sharpness and refinement. Refinement will change the topology. Will increase the amount of details of the NURBS surface. We can change sharpness. We can change the divisions on face. And for a second approach, we can use the another workflow using the two other inputs of the CurveClay operator. So let's copy and paste our setup, remove the project here, connect the vase to the first input. Then we can connect the circle to the second input, which is called REST3D faces. And then we also need to create some transform operator and connect it to the third input. Then the projection of curve onto surface will happen inside of CurveClay. We can choose different methods, also like minimum distance. And now we can try to play with these parameters. And then we can control the deformation. So here we are moving the circle, reducing the radius, and we can make some deformation, and that way we can create something interesting. So that was about the CurveClay, so two ways how we use it. If you like our tutorials, please not only follow our YouTube channel, where you will see more tutorials every next weeks, but also consider to check our website, where we uploaded 14 of my courses I created during last years, partly myself, partly in collaboration with different amazing artists. So we have three basic courses for Touch Designer, called Touch Designer Extreme, Touch Designer Extreme 102, and Houdini Extreme. We also have a bunch of intermediate courses oriented for different practical approaches, like creating audiovisual live streaming, media server development, using Touch Designer with Grandeme for light design, building your own VJ tools, and constructing the terrain pipeline. Also, we have four advanced courses where we speak about GLSL, geometry shaders, and 2D GLSL, and also about Python in sense of developing scripts, SOP, geometry tools, and also one course about the C++. Also, we have a bunch of new courses coming. So currently, we have AI machine learning course created by Vadim Epstein, and we also launching soon the audiovisual production using Bitwig and Touch Designer. And as last, we have How to Touch course, which is only one academical course about of common pipeline between Houdini and Touch Designer on the market.